ready to match the stars. Tab Hunter, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Taxi, Mary Lou Henner, Dick Martin, and Fanny Fly, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Ready, all set there? Already out there? Already up here? Let's see, she's wearing her cowgirl outfit.
Right.
Pretty?
Yes. She must be the bad guy.
Yeah.
That's why I've got black on.
That's right.
I'm an old cowhand from the Rio Grande.
Yes, there, here's the horseman.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I just found that out.
I've seen pictures of, yeah.
Spring.
You became a father last spring?
Yeah, this wonderful mare of mine had a lovely, lovely filly in Albuquerque.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, where is your farm?
Well, I've got a farm in Virginia.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I thought. I read someplace about that. Yeah. And you ride through the countryside, and do you go after the fox and all that?
I say, yes, we
no,
do.
No, he takes a cab. What do you
say? All right, here we have Judy Bates and Cherie Daniels. Now, the current champ is Judy. She has $1,200. How do you feel, Judy?
Pretty good.
You're getting there little by little.
Yes.
And we're meeting Cherie for the first time. We welcome you, my dear, and
thank
ask you, to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm single. I'm a native Californian.
Yeah.
And I work...
Isn't that funny? You say Brooklyn, they applaud. You say California.
Nothing.
Yes?
I work as an instructional assistant at a small elementary school, first, second, and third graders, which is really nice. And I just got back from a dream trip. My parents took me on, me and my sister, I should say, sister and I, to Israel. And I think they would like me to help them pay for it. So here I am. And I brought you a coin.
What is that?
It's a coin from Israel.
Oh, really? I've never seen one of those.
Don't try to buy any gum or anything if you go back. It's not worth too much.
All right. Thank you, Menachem.
You're welcome.
Daniels. That's very kind of you. Well, I'll leave it right here. It'll be a good luck talisman for you, and I'll collect it later. We'll start this game right after we do a little business with America. Shall we begin? Okay. Cherie, you may have A or B.
B.
B for Cherie, and she for me. Let me tell you how weird Weird Willie is. Oh. Boy. Oh. Not too good.
C-.
C-, really, yeah. You're going to have to rehearse a little. Weird Willie is really weird. He installed a revolving door in his blank. That's how weird Weird Willie is. Okay, Cherie, let me tell you how weird Weird Willie is. Yesterday, he installed a revolving door in his blank.
Bathroom.
Yeah! Bathroom. All right. Bathroom. What did you say to that?
Well, is that the same as John?
Yes, of course it is. That's one for Cherie. Show us your John.
Oh, no, he was really weird.
Well,
really?
That's weird to put a revolving door in a bathroom. That's weird.
No, I know lots of people have a kidney problem. They put a revolving door in so it never slows down. No, put a revolving door in his car.
In his car. That's weird.
I don't like them either.
Set in his refrigerator.
We're really getting the weirdos. Cherie is looking for a revolving door in El Jano. What do you say?
Bathroom.
There it is. That's two for you. And you, sir.
Cherie is doing very well today.
Oh, good.
Cherie, restroom.
Oh, there it is. That's most unusual for the first rounder, isn't it? All right, Judy, you got to go to work now and see if you can do a little catching up. You can always tell when Colonel Sanders has been out with one of the chickens. He comes home with chicken fat on his blank. Oh, aren't you having a good time? You know, you get paid, too. All right, here we go, Judy Bates. You can always tell when Colonel Sanders has been out with one of the chickens. He comes home with chicken fat on his blank.
On his lips.
On his lips. Well, yeah, he would be necking, kissing. What do you say?
Well, I got close to the lips. I said mustache.
On his mustache. All right. She says lips.
All right, you take back those boos now, or I'll know the reason why. Mouth!
Mouth. Good acting, isn't it?
Why?
Didn't she appear to be angry? I thought it was a good acting job.
Breath.
On his breath. Comes home with chicken fat on his breath. Judy Bates is looking for the answer. Lips, Mary Lou.
Well, it's close, but no cigar. Beard.
On his beard.
Beard?
Yes.
No, on his necktie.
Necktie. Wonderful. Yes. All those are good responses, aren't they?
Not particularly.
Oh, well, then you show us a good one.
All right. You remember the song? Chicken fat on my collar.
No, I don't remember
no,
that.
No, would you hum a few bars?
I'd like to hear more.
Chicken fat on my collar. So there we are at the end of round one. 4-1 the score. Round two coming up right after this. We are ready. This is the second and final round. 4-1 the score. Cherie, again, you have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B it is. Now, let's see. Four people were matched in the first round. Let's see. Charles and Brett, you are the only two who participate.
She loves this. She loves this.
It's called acting. There. The teenage pirate said to his pirate father,
"Yes,
Dad, I have nothing to wear tonight. Do you mind if I borrow your blank?"
No,
you don't. You don't play. But if you want to, all right. Okay. Right.
Can I hear that again?
Okay, Cherie. The teenage pirate said to his pirate father, "Dad, I have nothing to wear tonight. Do you mind if I borrow your blank?"
Your hook.
Your hook. That's not a bad answer. You know, there's Captain Hook. He had the... And then, of course, there are other possibilities, too. Peg leg?
No, this was a very loose... You know that whole thing about I dreamt I went to a party in my maiden form bra?
Right.
This was a very swinging party. She wanted to borrow his eye patch, and that's all.
Eye patch. You know, pirates have eye patches. She's looking for the hook.
His poker to... So we're all looking for the hook of life.
Yes, all right.
Something to hook it on. Polka, no, polka dot patch.
A polka dot polka patch. Dot what? Isn't that a nifty idea there? Now, Judy, here you are. You need 3 to tie, and you need 4 to win. Judy said. That's what it says here. My new fur coat must be made out of dog hair. Every time I wear it, it blanks. Every time I wear it, it blanks.
I mean, I don't.
You do not play.
Perfect.
You matched her in the previous round. Everyone else except Brett will participate. All right? Oh, splendid. Oh. Oh. You are a creative writer.
That's true.
Yes. Okay. Here we go. Judy Bates. Judy said, my new fur coat must be made out of dog hair. Every time I wear it, it blanks.
It sheds.
It sheds. She says, every time I wear it, it sheds, Tab. What'd you say?
I was thinking about that, but I said every time she wears it, it barks.
It barks, yeah. That would be a little more humor there than shedding, wouldn't it?
Yeah, but then it depends if it's long or short-haired.
Right? I already matched the first time around.
Okay, Chuck.
I thought it shed, but a coat sheds anyway.
Right.
So I said, stops at a fire hydrant.
Stops at a fire hydrant. Judy, you must match the 3 remaining people here in the lower tier to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Mary Lou, we come to you.
I'm sorry, Barks.
Barks. So that means Cherie Daniels wins the game. It sits up and gets Barks. Come on down, Cherie. Right here in a little blue dot there. I'll get the table out of your way. And we'll say goodbye to Judy Bates, who's leaving here with $1,200.
Thank you,
Judy.
Very much.
Okay. Now, here we are with Cherie Daniels. You ready to have a go at it?
Yes.
A lot of big money involved here. Let's see how you do. Cherie, we polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank of the night. If you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular response, $250, and $100 for matching the third. Cherie. All right, whom do you call on?
Dick.
Dick.
I would say it was the Academy Award-winning Heat of the Night.
Heat of the Night.
Tab.
Tab?
I would say the Still of the Night.
In the Still of the Night.
All right.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. An answer may come.
I have it. I'm just trying to keep the camera on me longer when I go, we already had Still of the Night, didn't we?
Yes, we've had Still of the Night there. There may be something on the card there that might be of interest to you.
In the middle of the night.
In the middle of the night. Middle of the night, in the heat of the night, and in the still of the night are the three they've given you. You have a choice of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own. What would you like to do?
In the heat of the night.
In the heat of the night. That was Dick's answer. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Ladies of the night. Let's hear it.
Wow.
How come you didn't think of that, Dick? All right. Maybe see the $250 number. In the heat of the night, I got $250 more, Cherie. What do you think's under the big one?
In the still of the night.
All right, slide it. In the still of the night. There it is. A wonderful song. Okay, that was Tab's answer, in the still of the night. And now you got $350 total. However, you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $2,500. That's the minimum you could play for. But if you get a lucky spin of the wheel, you double the money and play for $5,000. Give it a good hefty spin there. Must make one complete revolution. Here we go. Let's see if she plays for double the money or a straight $2,500. By George! Double! Danny, are you ready? Okay. All right, Cherie, good luck to you. Ready, Fanny? This is it. Rolled blank. That's R-O-L-L-E-D blank. Rolled blank.
R-O-L-L-E-D.
Yes. R-O-L-L-E-D. Rolled blank. Sometimes looking at it might help you suggest an answer. I'll let you look at it, too. You've got yours. Oh, she's all ready. Leave her alone now. Okay, Fanny, you ready? All right. Cherie, give us the answer that she's put on the card, and we give you $5,000. Rolled?
Around.
Rolled around? Rolled around. You don't like that answer? What would you say? Oats. They would all say rolled oats. What did you say, Fanny?
Give all of those people $3,500.
Rolled oats. Well, Cherie, you've improved your position a little bit. You have a total of $350. You're still the champ. You'll meet another player later. Right now, we've got this message for America. All right. Thank you, Danny Olson. Here we go. Let's say hello to Lisa Prevorn. Hello, Lisa.
Hi.
Lisa Prevorn.
Yes.
That's a pretty musical name.
Thank you.
Where are you from, Lisa?
Santa Monica.
Mm-hmm.
I've been married for 2 years. I work as a loan secretary in a savings and loan, and I'm really happy to be here.
Well, we're happy to have you, Lisa, and wish you the very best
Thank
of luck.
Thank you.
Are you ready to carry on?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Round one, Lisa, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B.
B it is. B says.
B.
Muggsy said. Oh, boy, the school I went to was so tough in driver's education class, they taught us how to blink. That's how tough the school was. In driver's ed, we learn how to blink. And it's tough school, see, Lisa? You see what I'm talking about?
Can I say that, please?
No, I'm not talking to you, sir.
You're right.
I was talking to Lisa. You interrupted me. I'm going to bust you right in the mouth.
Are you tough?
Lips move when he reads.
Everybody's ready except you, Charles. You have an answer? Don't say it yet. Have you thought about it?
Mm-hmm.
You got a good one?
I hope so.
All right. Now we're ready. Muggsy said school I went to was so tough. In driver's education class, they taught us how to blink.
To crash.
How to crash? How to crash? Well, I don't know. Crash is a difficult thing to do. I guess you have to be tough to crash. What do you say?
I said crash.
Oh!
What I was foofing around about, I was implying it was a losing answer. But so far,
actually,
I'm wrong.
I was going to say wreck. Same thing. Right?
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't stay awake another minute because I'm so exhausted.
From what?
I don't know, but I just got a crash.
Me too. Okay, Chuck.
Confucius say that MC go around says bad answer when the whole panel gets it should look for another job.
I have a mate too. I tell you, it didn't even cross my mind.
What crossed your mind?
Well, they taught us how to strip cars, you know, stuff like that. That would be a tough school. What'd you say?
I grew up in Chicago. Slash tires.
Slash tires. Yeah, very good there.
Steel hubcaps.
Steel hubcaps. Now we're getting to the real tough guys there.
Tough.
Yeah, that's really tough.
They were very tough.
How tough were they?
They taught them how to hit and run.
Hit and run. All right, these are my kind of people down here.
There's a criminal element on that.
That's true, absolutely true. Okay, Cherie, we got one for you. Charles Nelson Reilly said...
Oh.
And I quote...
Oh, Chuck.
Stewart, please.
He says... I've really lost a lot of weight. Even my blank doesn't fit anymore.
Charles, I have ever heard in my entire
All right, let's hear
life.
You imitate Charles Nelson Reilly.
I can do him when I'm not thinking about it. Wait.
Stinks already.
I'm not going to do his making.
With Gary Berghoff over here, he could do it because he was in his class. He's in. Even my blank doesn't fit anymore. How is that? Is that an improvement? No. Oh, thanks. You imitate Charles Nelson Reilly.
Well, I would say even...
Almost showed the answer. Holy man.
What happened? You
must pay attention,
Tab. Wait a second. Okay.
Ready, Chuck? We're just stalling for your benefit, Chuck. Oh, well, we'll edit all this weight out.
Dang.
Charles Nelson Reilly said, I really lost a lot of weight. Even my blank doesn't fit anymore.
I hate to say it, but toupee.
Well, I think he let the cat out of the bag a little bit earlier, didn't he? Yes.
Toop.
Toop.
That's one for her.
A mess. Rug.
Rug.
That's two.
I don't know what she's all talking about. Shoes.
Shoes. I agree. Tight shoes. Mary Lou.
Well, cap.
Cap.
Oh, his cap.
His cap.
The capo.
Got another toop.
Another toop.
All right, so it's going to stop. No way.
Now, what do you say to this?
Will she?
I don't mean this, but Brett told me. Wig.
Wig. Here we are at the end of round one. 4-3 is the score. Round two coming up anon. Now this. We have to say goodbye, but you will return next time, won't you, ladies?
Yes.
We'll pick up right with round two, 4-3 in favor of the champ, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Well, I've got to take my lucky coin with me here. All right. Let's see now. The name of your show is Taxi.
Taxi.
Taxi. Nice.
It is marvelous, and incidentally. I saw the run-through, and it's a marvelous show.
Yeah,
excellent.
So you got some... Oh, wonderful. And a star will be born.
Yes, indeed.
So
Six Guys and You?
That's right.
John Hirsch on that.
It was a better name for the show, incidentally. Six Guys and Her.
Six Guys and Her would be a good name. What's the name of your show?
It's called The Waverly Wonders, and it stars a marvelous superstar named Joe Namath.
Oh, we've got to look forward to seeing that. Yeah. And you're directing them. And you're spending time in the... Yes.
Don't forget our series.
Your series. What's it called?
The Bald and the Blind.
Oh, yeah. Too much. I hope you'll join us next time. I'm Gene Rayburn here. Tally ho!
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.